Hi everyone, today we are going to make a review of our client's Rek, who kindly allowed us to observe his private mining farm. By the way, he also has an air-cooled mining farm, which is in the same room. We will show it to you a little bit later. The air-cooled farm is shut down right now, for we could make a video without ASIC noise. So, the Rek is provided with a cooling tower and accommodates 24 ASIC S9J units. Now, let's have a look what's inside the cell and see how does the system work. Here are 6 ASIC S9J devices with 2.6 kW power supply units inside each cell. Before immersing, all coolers were dismantled and ASICs were cleaned from dust. Then, devices were immersed into our immersion liquid coolant, which is dielectric, non-toxic and possesses high thermophysical properties. By the way, the temperature of coolant right now is around 60 degrees. You can see it on the sensor. Now, I'll tell you about the way how the immersion cooling system works. Here we've got a large camera with mining devices and a small camera with heat exchanging equipment, such as pump and heat exchanger itself. A pump provides circulation and overflow of coolant from the large camera to the small one. Here you can see how the liquid transfer is actually carried out. Then coolant gets to the heat exchanger, where it is cooled with a water glycol mixture in a closed external circuit, which discharges the undue heat into the environment through a cooling tower. A few words about the Rek maintenance. As you can see, the cell is rolled out now, so we will close it and roll it back. As the cell is rolled back, we fix it to prevent an unexpected rolling out. And let's dismantle the console. Now, let me tell you about the external cooling circuit. It works on water glycol mixture. The liquid circulates through the whole Rek inside the frames, which serve as some kind of a collector, where the cooler is evenly distributed to each cell. Up here there is a hydraulic piping, which includes a pump, conservator, manometer, which shows the pressure level in the system, and a tap. Here is also a sensor that demonstrates the temperature, which is determined according to the variable speed drive and the cooling tower. The cooling tower is installed outside. We will show it to you a little bit later. Now, let's have a look at some parameters of the cooling tower. As we can see, the fan consumption is about 112 kW. And fan rotor speed is 23 Hz. Here we should take into account that this cooling tower is designed for the heat removal from the equipment up to 45 kW. As I promised, we went outside to have a look at our cooling tower. As you can hear, it is almost noiseless now at this time of year. As I've said before, the tower is designed for the removal of heat from equipment up to 45 kW at an ambient temperature of up to 30 degrees. And now it consumes only 120 watts to cool the 45 kW equipped Rek. And now the most important thing. The main benefit of using an immersion cooling system. The even and proper heat removal from equipment by immersion liquid allows to increase the ASIC's efficiency by up to 40%. and devices operating in high performance mode without a risk of overheating, what we will see on the monitor. Here you can see overclocked ASIC S9 using the Bixbit firmware. The hash rate of ASIC S9 is over 20.2 terahashes per second now. The chip's temperatures are 64, 67, 64 degrees, and the board's temperature is around 50 degrees. Devices operate in high performance mode without overheating and show a high level of efficiency. At the end of our video review, I would like to show you how the air-cooled farm works, which was shut down during the video. Bye everyone!